Hi, I'm Mike Thompson. Today I'm going to tackle a project that I've never done before. I'm going to build a solar panel. I'm involved with a little project and I was given these solar panels. These are Sunpower 5-inch Maxeon solar cells. These things appear to be absolutely amazing, so I'm really, really excited about these. The problem is there's very little, essentially no, how to assemble these anywhere online. And I've checked YouTube and every other place I could possibly think of, and there's just not a lot of good how-to assemble these. Well, I'm going to make the how-to right now. I've put three together to test, so the way I've been doing it does work. So I'm going to show you how we solder up these Maxeon solar cells. Now, I'm wearing latex gloves because I don't want to get any fingerprints on the front of the cell. These here were soldered face down on a piece of paper, which I thought was clean, although there must have been a little bit of grit or something on it because there's a couple scratches on the face of these now. That doesn't really seem to affect the power output much at all, though, so I'm happy to report that. I was surprised when I took these out of the box just how small and light they really are. These things are about 6/1000ths of an inch thick. Normally solar cells have all the little silver lines and things, and then you have to put the tabs on them, and then you have to do all that soldering. These have all their connections on the back, and this just really blows me away. So this is really, really simple to do. You don't have to solder on all those tabs, so it's a huge time saver. So you can see that the back side of the cell has all the lines on it. Inside each of these three white areas here is a little tiny dot. That's where I'm going to make the connection. I'm going to put a dab of flux on each of these little dots, and then I'm going to put a dab of solder on each one and then smash the dog bone down. This side, these three here over here are negative. These three over here are positive, as evidenced by a tiny little plus sign etched here in the outer two white zones. I've labeled these before, so plus in this case is this direction. So I'm going to turn my cell around and have plus go this way. I'm going to put the tiniest drop of flux right here on each of these three little dots. But make sure not to get the flux on the front, as it looks like this. This is why the paste is sometimes better than the liquid. I'm going to put a tiny bit of solder on the end of my soldering iron, and I'm going to drop it right here on this little dot inside the white zone. I'm going to do that three times. Now I'm going to butt this cell underneath the other tab of the adjacent one, making sure that I butt the whole thing up against my straight edge so that my line is straight. I'm going to check my spacing, and then I'm going to use the soldering iron to smash my little dab of solder in between here and the dog bone tab. Now you may need to apply pressure with a screwdriver or something while you go ahead and hold this down, but these tend to stay pretty flat, and so I didn't have to. And you can see now I've got a good connection. And so that one's soldered on. I'm going to repeat the process here for the negative side. Little dab of flux, just the tiniest dab of solder, because I don't want my solder going all over the place. I want it exactly where I intend it to be. It doesn't take much. I'm going to put my tab on there in just the right spot. The holes in this make it really easy to align it, so you can see right through where it should be. That's very, very handy. They really thought this little dog bone thing through. And the dog bones holes allow it to expand and contract such that your cells aren't going to crack as you encounter different temperatures throughout the year. Like I said, they really thought this through. Now I like to check it along the way to make sure that I'm getting what I'm supposed to. These cells put out 0.6 volts per cell. So just multiply your number of cells times 0.6 and that should tell you what you'll be at the end. So I'm going to show you here from start to finish just how fast it is to solder one whole cell on. And there we have our completed string of 7. Now I just need to turn this into an array of 35. And doesn't that look great? Wow. After this, I quickly found out that working on glass would have been much better. So I put a piece of glass on top of a table and lit it with halogen lights underneath. This allows me to compulsively check my connections as I go, and it allows me to assemble things with minimal amount of movement. Glass can also take the heat of soldering iron and drip solder, whereas plexiglass or some other material might not be able to. Now that we've got a how-to video out there, you guys can go solder these up yourselves. They are a bundle of fun, and it's so incredibly easy. You get 6 connections per cell, boom, and you're done. Go ahead and subscribe if you haven't already. I'm Mike Thompson, and thanks for watching. I really appreciate it.